Hi and welcome to my channel. My name is Sara and today we're gonna do a makeup tutorial. I really hope that you can see something what I'm doing. I don't know about the light. I tried to get like the daylight in and some of the light from up and I don't know if this is working. Also, I have new eyelashes. Do you like them? Before we start, please subscribe my channel if you want to see other videos from me. Put thumbs up if you like makeup tutorials. I am a beautician, but I have done some like fashion photography makeup and fashion show makeup and stuff like that. So I kind of tried to like give my advice to you about makeup. I am definitely not the best YouTuber to make duo makeup or like the most talented ever, but this is, I kind of wanted to show you how I do my own type of makeup. I think the lighting is a bit better now, so you can see something that is happening. I have already washed my face with this new Cosmopharma Micellar Cleansing Water from X3 series, and I have to say this is amazing stuff. This makes my morning and evening routine so much like easier and so much shorter. So I just put this on a cotton pad and then a cotton swab, whatever pad, and then I just wipe my face. Second thing that I did, I applied my face cream. I used X3 Q10 day cream, which is for all skin types, and it's anti-aging, firming and moisturizing, and it has SPF 25. The sun is shining today actually, so this is perfect for today. And then I used for my under eyes eye serum from Organic series, which is my favorite. And that's what I've done so far. We are ready to rumble. I'll get coffee first. Okay, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna prime my eyelids with foundation, and you can also use just a regular eyeshadow primer, but I usually do the priming with foundation and powder. That works the best for me. And I prime my whole eyelid and also my eyebrows, because I like to start with my eyeshadow. I use pigmented eyeshadows, opaque eyeshadows, so the fallout would kind of ruin my other makeup. I could use those kind of like tricks to put powder here or paper here while I do my eye makeup. But this is the thing, I've done this forever and this works for me, but you can do this like whichever way you think is good for you or which works for you. Then just a little bit of powder. It doesn't like matter which powder you are using for this, because it's just gonna be the primer. So if you have like a weird color or wrong or like a powder that you don't enjoy, you can use that for this thing. Let's have some coffee. The first thing that I'm gonna do is my eyebrows. At first I'm gonna brush my eyebrows with a spoolie tool, and I'm gonna brush them upwards like this. Then I'm gonna see if there's like extra hair there. There might be few, so I'm taking them off. And for this I use this kind of eyebrow shaver, or I don't know what you call it. And I just shave them off with this, because I don't like plugging my eyebrows. And then I'm gonna take an eyebrow pencil. I just bought this because my other one was like, I didn't have anything left. So I bought this from H&M actually, and this is called Brow Specialist, and this is the color Caramel Brown. It's kind of a light shade. It actually has a spoolie on the other end also. So I'm just gonna line my like down part, the under part of my eyebrow with it. Just slightly. And then what I'm gonna do is take the spoolie, whichever spoolie you're using, and brush the hairs downwards a bit. And then line the upper part. The upper part like this. Now we have the outline for the eyebrows. We're gonna take my... Then we're gonna take Pauli. Pauli wants to be in the makeup video. Then we're gonna take the Andrea Milan magnetic case, in which I have this kind of eyeshadow shade 7831, and this is just perfect for my eyebrows. And then I'm gonna have a brush. This, I don't know which brand it is, it's just number 0, and it's broken before, so I fixed it. And then I'm gonna add a bit of water and take the water and blend the water with the eyeshadow. Just gonna show you like this, and then pat it on my hand just that I have the right amount of the color, and it becomes like a liquid liner type of thing. And then I'm gonna take my brush and just measure here. This is where my eyebrow is gonna start. Then I just take this and do a line, and you can see it's different colored than the eyebrow pencil, but that's because I want my eyebrows to be like really like dark, but I like them to have many colors in them, like warmer and colder colors, so I get like, I think that way I could get like neutral. I don't know, but that works for me, so that's what I do. And then I do the eyebrows again with this color, the same lines I did before, and that makes my eyebrows really sharp. And it doesn't matter if you mess up at this point, because you're gonna fix it with some concealer afterwards. Next step is to take my Cosmopharma 2905 eyebrow brush, and then I'm just gonna use the same color and mix it with the water to have the perfect shade. And then I'm just gonna color in my eyebrows with it. And you can, if you want, you can do like the lighter bit on the front, but for my face it really doesn't. I've tried that so many times and I don't think that works. I have too much angles on my face and it makes my face look too like, I don't know, soft. You guys are probably gonna kill me, but I don't care. I don't care. This is just, this is how I do my eyebrows. You can do yours as you wish. You should use a lot of color for the arch or the like tail part, because that's the one you can't really see in photos usually, so that's where you need the most color. And now the next part is like an angled contouring brush. I have this kind of like, this is called Coastal Secrets. I have no idea where this is from, but this is like an angled concealer brush. And then I'm gonna use my Essence Soft Touch Mousse Concealer, and I'm just gonna take some of it and just do my under, do the under of the eyebrows with this, and just fix all the mess we made before, or I made before. And this also makes your eyebrows pop. This is kind of like highlighting your eyebrows. Then I'm just gonna do the same thing for the front part, like this and like this. And up we go. And then the top part. Okay, so that's the eyebrows. They are done. Next thing we're gonna do is the eyeshadow. At this point, if you like to use eyeliner, you can do that in which way ever you wish. I don't really like to use eyeliner anymore, and also with these lashes, it's just too much. I think it makes my eyes a lot smaller, and the black liner makes me look like older, and I don't like that, even though I am 18. So I'm gonna do my eyeshadow. I'm gonna start with the eyeshadow base, and I'm using my Guerlain eyeshadow palette, and this is called 93 Rue de Passy, or something like that. I'm gonna take my eyeshadow brush, which has, it's called Smoky Eye, and it's just a small rounded thing, and I'm going to use the lightest shade of brown there, this one, and do the base. I'm just gonna put it on my crease and a bit over the crease, and you don't really have to blend at this point. And then just to build the color up, I'm gonna use the next shade from this, which is this one, over the last one we did. And this one I'm gonna just put a bit more on my like moving part of my lid, which, what is it called? So yeah, and over the part we did with the base. And now I'm gonna take my blending brush, which is same type of brush that we just used, but it's bigger. And it's this rounded one, and the label has worn off. So I'm just gonna blend this towards my eyebrows. And next thing we're gonna do is do the under the eyebrows. Under the eyebrows, we're gonna use the color from my Andrea Milano Magnetic case. I don't quite know if they have this color anymore, but this is color 7818, and this has like glitter in it. It's a white with glitter. And I'm gonna use another like rounded type of brush for this, and also this, oh, this is also Coastal Secrets brush. And I'm gonna take the white and go under my eyebrow like this. And then I'm gonna take my blending brush and blend the two colors together a bit. Next thing is I'm gonna use my Technique palette, Technique Bronze eyeshadows palette. And for this makeup look, I'm using the type of like kind of like a rose gold eyeshadow. And I'm gonna take the other like rounded brush again. Pack the color in and just gonna do the crease part with it. And this is like kind of like a metallic rose gold color. And then I'm gonna take some of it and pat it on the corner of my eye. Next step is to take a different kind of brush and put, this is like a smaller eyeshadow brush from makeup store number 105, and this is kind of a small eyeshadow brush, and I'm gonna take the same color and just put it under my eye like this. The next step is to do the moving lid part of my eye. We're gonna use a white eyeliner and the yellow from the bronze technique palette and a lighter. And this is the trick I do like all the time. Melt the liner and put it on my hand. You can use whichever brush you want. I use the angled concealer brush from Coastal Secrets. I take some of the white and I just put it on the eyelid like so, and it makes it like really white, like opaque white. And then I'm gonna take the rounded eyeshadow brush again, and then I'm gonna use the like a yellow shade from the bronze palette. I'm gonna put this over the white like this, and then I'm gonna do a bit more blending. I do blending with some color on my brush. I'm gonna take something from the Guerlain palette, and it is the lightest metallic shade. I say take some of it on the brush and just start with the under the eyebrow and just start blending. And blending with this color, it makes it a bit easier because it slides better. So this is a nice trick that I learned. And that's it for the eyeshadow. Then because I have my lashes, I don't need mascara on my upper eyelashes. So I'm just gonna brush them with a spoolie. The spoolie brush from makeup store. I'm just gonna brush them. And then I'm gonna put some mascara on my lower lashes. And for those I'm using Andrea Milano XL Lash Advanced Mascara, which is my favorite. And then I'm gonna do another coat with this volumizer mascara. I like my lashes to be kinda dark and like extravagant. At this point I would actually also put on my fake eyelashes, but I don't really need them right now, so I'm not putting them on. So we're gonna do the makeup base next. I decided that my eyeshadow needs something to be a bit more dramatic, so I'm using a bit of this red Grimace shadow. So I'm just gonna do that real quick and just put it in the same place where I put the rose gold. Okay, then we're gonna do the base. And this is a good trick for if you have really like dry skin. This is what I did after when I was sick, because my under eyes were really, really black, but they were also like really, really dry from being sick. Even before I put on primer, I use Andrea Milano Triple Concealer, the yellow shade, and I'm gonna take Makeup Store brush 206. I'm gonna take the yellow and I'm gonna pat it under my eyes, only in those parts where it is dark. And you can use, it doesn't matter if your under eyes are so dry that it kind of like packs up in the creases. It's kind of doing that for me also, I don't know if you can see. Now, we're gonna take my primer. And I'm gonna be using the Andrea Milano Clear Primer. I'm gonna put it on with this, my silicone sponge. I'm just putting it on all over my face. And then I'm gonna do the under eyes. And I'm gonna go over the yellow. And that makes it a bit more like smoother. And now we're gonna go to the foundation. And I'm gonna be using my Andrea Milano Cover Solution 651. So I'm gonna be putting on the foundation with my brush. And I don't need a lot of foundation at this point. I'm just gonna use it for kind of like a base for the stuff that I'm putting on next. And then I'm gonna use my Beauty Blender. Pat it on, pat it on. Then I'm gonna use LA Girl Pro Concealer highlighting one. It's almost finished. I've used all of it. I really like. Gonna go here with it. And here. Bit of it on the nose. Then I'm using L.A. Girl Pro Concealer in a shade Porcelain. That I'm gonna be using under my eyes a bit. Triangle shape. Pat it on. Then I'm gonna take a bit of Illuminator Instant Luminosity Highlights and Accentuals from Kix, and I really like this. This is a really good one. I'm just gonna take some of it with a brush, Cosmopharma 2911. Just put it here where my highlight would be, a little bit on here and on my nose and here. And then, because I like my under eyes to be really bright, I like to use the Andrea Milano Cover Solution 300 under my eyes. Here, and this is optional if you don't like your under eyes to be almost like white or dull, like you don't really have to do this, but this is what I do to make my face look like a doll's face, which those of you who have been with me from the beginning, you know that I like to look like a living doll. And I'm just gonna go with a beauty blender. Really goodly. Goodly is not an English word, I think. And then we're gonna do the baking. And for the baking, I'm using mixed product. I'm mixing Rimmel London Match Perfection powder. Loose powder and Andrea Milano loose powder. And this is the shade 001 and this is the shade 5. And I'm putting it on with my beauty blender. And now, while my face is baking, I will take my Essence Lash and Brow Gel Mascara, which is clear. And I'm gonna go with it and go through my eyebrows with it. Then I'm gonna take my Essence Shape Your Face contouring palette. I'm gonna be using the warm brown for the... I do this thing called base for my contouring. So I'm gonna do contouring on contouring. So I'm gonna take this brush, which I really like, and it is actually from H&M, and I absolutely love it for contouring. So I'm taking this color, I'm doing some contouring with it. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the same color with it, our eyebrows, which is eyeshadow, Andrea Milano 7831. Let's go over the line we just did. So we're gonna do some blending. My favorite thing for the blending is my Cosmopharma 2910, which is not really a blending brush. It is, I think it's a powder brush, if I remember correctly. You might remember this. And I'm taking some of the Cosmopharma Andrea Milano translucent powder, like just a little bit. I'm gonna blend out the harsh lines. Okay, I had to change my memory card, so here we are again. Now to the highlight. And for the highlight, I'm gonna be using two products. I'm gonna be using the Ultimate Bronzing Powder from H&M and Andrea Milano Mineral Eyeshadow 60. It's called Champagne or something like that. And for that, I am using Cosmopharma 2902. And first I'm gonna take the Ultimate Bronzing Powder from H&M. Let's do the highlight. Where you would use highlights. Then I'm gonna be using the other one. And I like my highlights to be like really crisp. And that's why I use my finger to do it. So if you wash your hands, use your clean fingers, take some of the product on your finger and just put it on. And then I'm gonna highlight my nose. And now we're down to the lips. And I'm gonna be doing like big red lips today. And for the lips, I'm just gonna prime them with foundation and powder. First I'm gonna take some foundation, which I had left on my hand. And I have some powder on my beauty blender. And then first I'm gonna be using like a kind of like a neutral lip pencil from Andrea Milano to make my lips a bit bigger. And this is Andrea Milano lip pencil 550. And I'm gonna overline my lips. And I don't actually have really big lips, but and I don't remember where I like learned this trick to first use the neutral pen and then build up the product. So that's the thing that I do first. Then I'm using like a darker pencil or pen, and I don't know the brand of this one, but it's kind of a same shade but only darker, almost brown. My cat is awake again. She's singing to you. Then I'm gonna take lip color to go from H&M. The shade is called Zinfandel. I don't know what that means. And I'm just gonna go here. The last step is I'm gonna use my Gibest. I don't know what this is called. Gibest lip cream color. This is the shade 616. I'm just gonna go over the dark. It makes it kind of like a bit more bloody colored. I don't know. And do I have lipstick on my teeth? And there you have it. And the last thing I'm gonna do is use my Perfect Finish Face Mist from Kix. And this is awesome if you're thinking about buying a face mist to set your makeup or setting spray and you don't have a lot of budget for it. So this is a cheap one. I really like this and it smells awesome. So here's the finished look. I hope you enjoyed my tutorial. I'm gonna go to the city today, and tomorrow or in the evening I'm gonna film the swap video for you. Thank you for watching. Put thumbs up if you like makeup videos and you would like to see more of them from me. Please subscribe my channel if you want to see my videos. You can also like me in Facebook. My name there is Sara. And also my names in Instagram and in Snapchat are Kasmirocker. So you can follow me there also. Thank you for watching and bye!